Hello everyone, welcome back to the channel. I am Nikhil Kumar. Today I am going to show you how to build a simple interactive web app using Python and Streamlit. By the end of this session, we will have a personal dashboard with an intuitive UI, all coded step by step. And in future video, we will explore how to extend this for ML and data science use case. So let's get started. Before we start, make sure Python is installed on your system. To install Streamlit, simply run this command in your terminal, pip3 install Streamlit. So it will install the Streamlit using the Python. Streamlit is installed. So now let's get started writing our Python code to create a dashboard. So I'm going to create one file, that is app.py. So inside this, I'm going to import a Streamlit library for building an app, that is import Streamlit as st. Along with that, I'm also importing pandas for handling data and numpy for generating random numbers. So import pandas as pd, and I'm also importing the numpy as np. Now I'm going to set a page title. So let me add a line for that. Set streamlit.set page underscore config, and I am going to give a page title that is my dashboard. And I'm going to give a layout that is equal to wide. This set up the app's title and layout. With this much of code, Streamlit already gives a responsive app framework. Let's see how it works. Let me save this file and run the Streamlit run app.py. With this single command, it will give a dashboard to be created. Now let's try to access this page on the browser. And we can see that browser came up, and we can see the title is my dashboard of that particular application. Now makes it more interactive and customize its experience. So for that, let me close this process and update the same code. So inside this code, I'm going to add sidebar for this. So for that, st.sidebar.title. So let's give a title to as well. So that is user experience. Now I'm going to add a drop-down option. So for that, I'm going to use a theme here and as a variable. And inside that, I'm going to use the sidebar and dot select box. So this will give a drop-down box to the users. So inside this, I'm going to give a name, choose a theme. And inside this, I'm going to give two options to the user, that is light and dark. So this drop down let user switch between light and dark theme. For now, it's just a placeholder, so it's not operational, but it's a kind of a placeholder so that user can see the drop down options here. So let's add a checkbox as well. So for that, I'm going to define the variable show chart, and inside that, I'm going to use a sidebar dot checkbox, and inside that, I'm going to give like show chart as a checkbox, and inside that I am going to provide a value true. This checkbox allows user to toggle whether to display a chart or not, and it will be an operational one. So let's run the Streamlit command again to see how it works, and let me refresh the same page again. And we can see that we are getting that user experience as a sidebar title. We are getting a theme here, light and dark. This is not operational. And we are getting a checkbox to show chart or not. So we will add the chart as well. Let's modify the same file again. So let's make it more dynamic. So for that, what I'm going to do, I'm going to add greetings here. So for that, I'm going to define name and using some text input, so that user can enter their input, enter your name. And by default, I'm giving some name that is guest here. And then I'm going to use a write, so that whatever the user will give an input, so it will write on the screen itself. So for that, format it string, hello, and name, that is user input, and close. So this greeting dynamically updates as the user types their name. Streamlit handles live update without needing a page reload. Let's run this again. Streamlit run app.py and let's refresh the page again. There's a typo over there. Let me update the code. I didn't notice it shows here as well. So that is text underscore input. Let me run this again and we can see it's running. So let me refresh it. As you can see, it's giving a hello guest as a default value. So let me update this value here and print Nikhil. So as we can see, it's dynamic. I have added the name over there and it shows hello Nikhil. So at the left hand side of the tab, we have given a checkbox that is show chart. So let's make it functional. So for that, let's update the same code. So I'm going to add a condition here. If show chart, then it will create a chart over there using the pandas library, that is pd data frame. And let me use numpy here to randomly generate some numbers, that is random from 20 to 3. And we will add some columns here. So I'm giving some categories here, category A, category B, and category C. Square bracket close, and we will close this one as well. And we will add one line as well, line chart, and it will show the data. And if checkbox is not selected, then it will print some message over there. So for that, I'm going to add a else condition here, st.write. So to print something on the screen, we can use a write, just like we have added for the name as well. That is chart hidden, enable it from the sidebar. When the checkbox is enabled, it shows a random dataset as a line chart. If it is disabled, a message is displayed instead. So let's see how it works. So let me refresh the page. Oh, there is a typo in the columns here. So let me modify this. Okay. Where it is, columns. As we can see, it worked fine. Let me refresh it again. As you can see, we are able to see the chart. And if we click on this checkbox, it will hide this particular chart and it will print the screen which we have mentioned over there, chart header, enable it from the sidebar. Let's divide this page and make it more dynamic. So I'm giving some random values here. I'm going to divide the page into three sections for metrics like revenue, users and performance. So let me modify this again. So colon 1.metric. Let me define the metrics first. That is colon 1, colon 2, column 3 equal to st dot columns and 3, because we are dividing into three sections. And now we are going to define the metrics for that. Column 1 dot metric, and I'm giving some random values here. Revenue, some value to that, that is 10k, and some percentage like plus 5%, colon 2, because we are separating it into three sections. Let me give some users, it's a string, separate it and give some users number here, that is 1.2k, and plus the how many percentage it go up plus 10%, and colon 3 dot metric, that is performance, that is 98%, we can give something like that, some random value, and plus 2% here. So this metric display key stats with percentage changes. This layout is sleek and professional for dashboards. So let's see how it works. Let me run the same command again. As we can see, it worked fine. There is no error in the code. Let's refresh this page. As we can see, we have segregated into three sections, that is revenue, users and performance, and it shows the particular value as well. As we can see, we have specified the hard-coded values over there and it's printing those things. Similarly, we can make it more dynamic by putting some metrics or reading some metrics from the Prometheus exporter or something like that if we are creating some kind of a node exporter. Now let's add an expander for an info. So for that, like if we want to give some kind of expander kind of option to the user where we can give about us or some kind of a help section, so we can use this particular block here. Let me go to the end of the file and let me update this, that is with st.expander. I'm giving a name, that is about this app, and inside that I'm going to print two keywords, that is write this app demo the power of Streamlit. I'm going to create another one, that is st.write, and input, I'm giving some random keywords here, input, that's all. This expander are collapsible section, great for including tips or documentation. So let me run this Streamlit app and it worked fine. Let me refresh this again. As we can see, we got an about this app option, and we can see these are the string which we have specified into that option. In this way, we can add some kind of about section about the app and what is the use of this particular charts and all. So this will be very helpful options in our application to show the information about the application. And that's it for today. We have just built a fully interactive dashboard using Python and Streamlit from scratch. In the next videos, we will cover how to extend this for machine learning and data science projects. If you found this helpful, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. See you in the next video. Have a nice day.